Hello, and welcome to 5 Minutes of Postgres. My name is Lucas, and today we're going to start a new series on 5 Minutes of Postgres called Postgres Planner Quirks. When we say quirks, we mean odd behavior that might make sense to you if you're a Postgres hacker, but certainly is confusing when you're an end user, like a DBA, data platform engineer, or application developer. And so we'll start with a very common quirk today, which is how Postgres behaves when you have a limit and order by a clause and picks the wrong index. So this is something that I've actually seen many times on production, and we'll walk through a few examples of how this can happen and what you can do to resolve issues like this. So here, just to show you what we mean, is on Stack Overflow, this is a question from many years ago, keeps being asked in different variations over the years. People are asking, when they execute a query like select star from items, where object D equals something, limit one, this works as expected, but then once I add an order by ID, the different column that is not the one we're filtering by, then suddenly it's slow. And the fast query in this case is correctly using the index on our filter clause. The slow case is surprisingly using the primary key index, and it has a very high rows removed by filter. Now here in this example, you can see the difference between the fast version is 0.029 milliseconds, really, really fast, and 800,733 milliseconds. This is longer than 10 minutes to finish that slow version. Now let's take a look at a particular example that was posted to the pgsql-performance mailing list back in 22. Andre asked here, why is my query behaving odd? The nice thing is that Andre actually did provide us with a full working test case, which is always very helpful to have, which does surface this primary key incorrectly being used. And so I'll reproduce this locally just to show you how this looks like. So we're first going to create this orders test table, and then we're inserting 2 million records into it. And then we're running analyze. Analyze will capture the column statistics, which are relevant for making planner decisions. Now we're also going to create an index. This is the index that we want our query to use. And we're going to run our query now, and you'll see that this is essentially the behavior we want, which is picking the index that we have, and it runs in less than a millisecond. Now, Andre kind of has an extreme case here that he showed, but I think this oftentimes does show up in slightly less obvious cases, which is he essentially had skewed data, where now there is 100,000 records with just one particular timestamp. And then he analyzes it again. Now there's a second thing that's relevant in this particular example, which is the fact that we are looking for a range. If you have a cluster of values that behave different than others and you are doing a range comparison, then this is one of the cases where this will happen to you quite badly. The same query that we were running previously finished in 0.09 milliseconds, now it takes 155 milliseconds. Now, of course, both the physical structure of the table as well as the statistics have changed. So one could argue this is actually the right index, right? Because now what Postgres is saying is I will actually use the primary key index to fulfill the order by limit. And the assumption is if I look through the index, then I'll be able to find rows quickly. Essentially, the summary here is that the Postgres planner will estimate that it will hit 50 rows that satisfy the filter condition before it's gone very far in the primary key index. Now, in this example, what we're seeing is that the shipping date column we're filtering by and the primary key are correlating in the wrong direction. And so Postgres makes a very over-optimistic guess. And back in 22, Tom noted that he doesn't think Postgres has adequate stats yet to detect this sort of problem. And so just to illustrate to you, if I debug a problem like this, what I like to do is I like to use PG hint plan, not to fix it permanently, but just to understand what Postgres is misestimating. And so we'll take a look at the table here, and we're going to essentially write a query hint on our explain analyze, and we're just going to force it to use the index that we think it should be using. And so here now you can see that if it were to use the index that we wanted to use, it would only take 44 milliseconds versus 155 milliseconds. Now, why is Postgres using the wrong index here? Really, it comes down to cost. So you can see in the plan that we see here, we get a cost of 35 on the limit, versus in the good plan that we wanted to use, we get a cost of 43,000. Postgres is really optimistic and thinks that essentially if it just looks for 50 values, it will quickly find matching rows and thus will be able to terminate early. There were a few other things that people have written about this over the years. For example, also back in 22, Lawrence Jones, back then on the Koharlis team, wrote about how they've run into this problem with the Postgres Query Planner. And so what they determined was it came down to the end distinct measurement in the pgstats data that the Postgres Planner maintains. And so what they were able to do back then, and I think this is one way to resolve this issue, is to just increase the default statistics target. And what the increasing default statistics target will do is it will sample a larger portion of the table. And so what that will do is it will help you get the right estimate and as such discourage the bad plan. Another thing I'll mention here, if you do not have a particular need for an order by condition like this, it can actually make sense not to have that condition. Oftentimes ORMs just generate that by default. Like all Ruby on Rails versions, for example, love to add that. And if you don't actually need that guarantee that it's ordered by the ID, then just removing the order by also resolves this problem. I want to mention one more thing. Cassidy posted one weird trick for speeding up order by that you probably shouldn't use. And so the idea here is we're adding a plus zero to the order by. Let's see if we can do this with the example we had earlier. And so now we can see that in this case, it is picking the right index. And really what Postgres is doing here is because you have this expression now in the order by, it no longer thinks that the index fulfills the expression, despite, you know, the plus zero not really taking any effect. And so this now lets you just fix the query by essentially adding this nonsensical plus zero into the query. Thank you, Cassidy, for sharing this tip. I would probably prefer this over pg hint plan if I couldn't figure out why the statistics were bad. The community, by the way, is aware of people using this trick to fix things. So despite there being a lot of pushback in the community around hints, I would expect this to be fairly stable across releases just because people know that this is one of the ways that people resolve this quirk in the Postgres Query Planner. Thank you so much for listening. This was 5 Minutes of Postgres. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to hear about next week's episode, and talk to you next week.